I'm back with a new video. In this video, we'll be creating a simple REST API for our Messenger system. It will be a very simple API that will be handling all the requests that we had learned in the previous video. We'll also be learning what a middleware is in this process, and we'll be creating that simple REST API to understand the structure of how we can define our route handlers to handle the requests that are coming from the client. For the client, I will be using Postman that you can install it. You can Google it as it is a Chrome extension and just launch the app. Okay, so let us start with the coding of the REST API. In the process of developing the REST API, I will tell you each and every concept in detail. So stay tuned, guys. Let us initialize the Express project. I will say npm init, and this will initialize the Express for us. Just press enter. And then you will simply install Express. Okay, but I have already installed Express. So as you can see in the package.json, I have already defined Express. So you simply can install Express using npm install and just write the name of the third party module, which in this case is Express, and it will get installed. So let us start with the coding of the API. The very first step is to require the Express package. Const Express require Express. So this will spit out the Express package for us as an object which we can store in the Express variable. Now let us say const app Express, and let us define it as an invocation to Express. We will be storing whatever is returned from this Express function. This will get assigned to the reference app. On the app, you will have certain methods that you can chain, like app.get to make a get request. You can see my snippet extension is showing all these thing you can do on the app now. App.all, delete, disable, enable, listen for listening to a specific port. So we'll see this. Okay, now let us now listen to a specific port. I will say port number 1337, and then we say app.listen port. Then we will define a callback. Once we are listening on the port, I will log to the console that server is now running on port. Okay, just using string interpolation, template strings. So now let us spin our server by saying node server.js. And you can now see in the log, it is giving a service now running on port 1337. So let us try this in browser and try making a request with browser as the client. Okay, so we'll say localhost 1337 and just press enter. So it says cannot get slash. Why? The reason behind this is we are making a get request now, but the get request is not getting place because we have not defined a route handler. Okay, so it is not able to handle the request when we haven't defined what we should do when the get request on slash comes. So this is our duty to define the API in a form that it serves. The client will be able to consume data only when the server is sending the data at a certain route handler that the client is visiting on. So let us define a route handler, and we'll simply say app.get on the slash when the client requests on the route slash making a get request. The app will listen, this Express app will listen for the request, and it has a response object which will help it to send a response. It will send a response using response.send, and it can send say hello world. And let us now run our server again by simply closing it and again say node server.js. Let us now reload this, and you can see we are getting hello world. Why? The reason behind this is simple. We are now handling the whatever request we are making. That is, what should our Express server do when it listens for the request on slash? It will listen the request. It will have a response object using which it will send the response back to the client who is making the request. Okay, So this was simple case. Now we can use this concept to define a simple route to fetch all the messages that will be hard-coded messages in our case, but we can work with a database like MongoDB as well, which we'll see in later videos. But before understanding this, let us understand how we can create GET requests for our Messenger API. Okay, so let us start with the code. First thing, I will define an array of messages, and I will simply have some bunch of messages in this, where say ID, where each message will be of the form ID set to 1, say name, who is sending the message, say Sean, content, prepare the tutorials, red is false. Then let us define ID 2, name is Pratik, content is again prepare the tutorials, read is false. Lastly, one more message I should define now. ID is 3, name is the nerdy dev, content let us learn express, read is true. Okay, so this is our messages, an array of messages that will be serving on the GET request to a specific route that the user will be making. So let us suppose the route is slash messages and we are making a GET request. Okay, so here we will be getting what? We will be getting a request object, the response object, and we will simply say response. We'll send the response in form of JSON now. Okay, I want this array of messages, which is an array of objects where each object is a message. I want to stringify that and send it in form of JSON. So this is what response.json will do. So we'll simply send the messages back to the client. Okay, let us try making the request now. Simply quit the server and rerun it. But now we will be making a request using Postman now. Okay, so here's our Postman client. Simply we are defining Messenger system request collection. You can create using this new collection on this icon, and then we'll simply say HTTP localhost 1337 slash messages. Okay, so let us send the request, and you can see we are getting the data back to our console of Postman client. Okay, so this is how we do a GET request. So let us try to fetch a specific message. Say I want to fetch a message pertaining to the ID 1. Okay, I want to fetch only this JSON object and nothing else. So for doing that, let us define a specific route. This was the GET request for retrieving all the messages. Now let us define a GET request to retrieve a specific message, and I will say app.get then messages, and then we will say colon ID, which is a placeholder, okay, pertaining to which ID I want to receive the message or I want to fetch the message. The app will listen for the request, will serve the response, and now what you need to do is you need to basically get the message from the array of messages using this ID. Okay, but there's a very special thing you need to understand. When the user or your client is making a GET request using this syntax, using slash messages slash say one, I want to fetch that one. Okay, that one is basically a parameter that is attached on the request of the client. So on the request that the user is making, there is an object called params, okay, on which you will get all these properties that we are defining using colon and whatever placeholder it is. So let us see what we get as rec.params. So let us say node server JS, and back to our Postman, simply define an ID, messages one, send the get request. And see, we are not getting any response because we haven't sent a response. We're just logging something to the console. Get back to our editor and you can see ID is coming out to be one. Okay, so what does this mean? The request has a params object on which this ID is basically sitting. Now what we can do with this ID is, we will be able to get the message when we say rect.params.id. Okay, so this you should keep in mind. Okay, whatever placeholder we define using colon, those will be defined on rect.params, request.params. Okay, so now the one thing now we need to do is we need to simply get the message by the message ID. I will say message ID and I will say rect.params.id, or simply destructure this. We can say ID, rename it as message ID and rect.params. Okay, now what you need to do is you need to simply get this message from the array of messages that we are having. So const message, I will say messages dot find, using the find method, and for each message I want to get that message where the message dot ID is equal to this message ID. And let us log the message to the console. console.log message. Let us rerun our server and let us try making the request now. So this will again not work because we're not sending the response, but you can see we are getting undefined. Now what is the reason behind that? Okay, so the rect.params that you're getting, the message ID is in form of a string, so you need to convert it to an integer because we are using IDs as integers. Okay, so what you can do here is you will simply compare the parseInt version of this message ID. You will say parseInt message ID. Now let us try making the request again. And back in our Postman, we are making the request. This will not serve us anything because we are not sending the response. And here we get the very specific message that we were wanted to fetch. So we're getting the message to the console. Just serve it to the client by saying response.json message, and this will work. But before that, again, we need to close the server and run it. Let us send the get request. And we are getting the JSON back to our Postman console. Okay, but suppose in this case, if we hadn't got the message we were trying to find, suppose I was looking for an ID 7, which does not exist in the collection of messages that we have defined in the hard-coded format. So what we can say in that case is, if the message does not exist, means the message is undefined, you are not able to find any message pertaining to the ID that we are looking for, you simply say return response.json. We can also set a status, and you should know that 404 is a status code for not found resource. Okay, and serve JSON, and then we can say in this JSON we can simply say message, let us say a note. Okay, and say message pertaining to this ID does not exist. Okay, and if the message pertaining to the ID exists, we will send the response in form of JSON. So this is our second route handler to fetch a specific message. So now let us rerun our server, and I'm back to the Postman client. Send the request. We are getting the response successfully. Okay, but if I change the ID to say 9 and then send the request, we will get a note back that message pertaining to this ID does not exist. Okay, so this is how we create a get request using Express. So this is our basic server API that we have created till now. We'll be working with post request, delete request, understand middleware in the next video. So thanks a lot, guys. If you're loving the content, please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in the next video.